Episode 2069, Is the Juice Worth the Squeeze?
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop sign,
watching people drive by. Happy day. It is a beautiful day in the neighborhood, and I hope you're having an extraordinary week. It is Wellness Wednesday, and I got a question for you. Is the juice worth the squeeze? For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. Is the juice worth the squeeze? You know, healthy living is demanding for many, many people. Whether you are blessed with good health or struggle to meet your health goals, decisions are made that affect you every day. Nutrition matters. A healthy lifestyle is not just comprised of physical activity and sleep. Oh, no. Diet is life-changing. And not that diet word that says you can't do something. It's all about what you can. Just ask someone who has struggled with healthy living. It's not only about eat less, exercise more. That game plan works only for a short burst of time. If you want to sustain a healthy lifestyle, it needs to include physical activity, good sleep, and a well-rounded diet. Not a well-rounded tummy, I'm just saying. But unfortunately, the reduction of chronic diseases like heart disease, cancer, and the maintenance of a healthy weight are not enough to hold our feet to the fire for promoting well-being via a healthy diet. We would rather take the easier way out and not take the time to prepare meals, make grocery lists for great food, and eat food from our own kitchens. Going out is the name of the game. Easy. Now, I'm all for going out, but not for every meal, not every single day. There is so much junk in the food we eat at restaurants. You can save money and save your heart by eating in more than eating out. So, is the juice worth the squeeze? Yes. Preparation and planning, the heart of a healthy diet. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Prepare and plan. I like to say prep and plan. Sounds more exciting. Preparation and planning are the squeezes you need to live out a healthy lifestyle. The results from the prep and plan are the juices for your everyday. What you do matters, especially in the kitchen. Happiness is homemade, not going out to your fast food restaurant. Yes, I'm all for supporting businesses, but I'm also in support of your health. You matter. If you want that healthy lifestyle bad enough, prep and plan. So what does that look like when it comes to real life application? It's not just about regurgitation, it's about application. So number one, prepare for the week. Don't try to be the super cook. Yes, put on that cake. I am super cook and have the whole month planned out. Yeah, it's not going to work. Why? Because life happens. Take it 1 week at a time. And if you can, you can do it for 3 days at a time. Usually the 3 day span works instead of just working 1 day at a time, unless you can walk to the grocery store, literally. Otherwise, you got to think about how much gas and how much time you spend going to the grocery store. And during now times, today, and what we're looking at with COVID-19, you've got all the kids home. Things are a lot different now. So it's really important for you to look at a longer span. So if you can plan for the week, that would be great. And if you're like, I don't know where to start with your children and your husband. Start with your spouse. Ask your children. Say, you know what? What is your favorite meal your mom fixes? What is it? Now, if dad's the cook, then have your husband, ask the children, what is your favorite meal that I cook or meals that I cook? Make that list. Know what they love. And then start from there. Okay, we know that they like these five things. All of them do great. That's 5 out of 7 days taken care of for dinner. Now, if they're home and they're schooling, whether it's because their virtual schooling, whether you've decided to homeschool them, whatever the case may be, maybe they're not of age to go to school and you're at home with them, then guess what? You can look at lunches and then you can look at breakfasts. What you can do to make things a little easier. But it takes what? Preparation. Ask and you shall receive. I promise you. I've done this with my kids, even at their age now. And they are ranges 16 now to 24. Now, my 24, of course, she's married, about ready to have a baby here in a few weeks. We're so excited, by the way. More on that to come. You know I'm going to have lots of info on that, but I'm trying to give them some privacy because it's exciting for them. It's their first. And so I don't want to spread everything all over the globe, but I'm telling you one thing, this is one proud grandma to be, and I just cannot wait to hold our little one. Okay, so I digress. So let's get back on track. Prepare for the week. If you can, do it for that week. And if not, look at it 3 days. I'm very blessed. My grocery store is literally just 2.5 blocks away. I can walk. Now, there are times that I choose to walk, and other times I'm like, yeah, I'm not fighting the humidity. I'm driving in the car and I'm walking back, especially if I got to get a lot of milk. We go through a lot of milk in this household. And so it's really hard to carry more than just 2 gallons of milk. It gets really heavy. So really think about what works in your schedule. If you're taking your kids out and they have an activity, can you shop during that activity? Maybe that's when you go and you take your list and stick to your list. Don't go over, don't go under, stick to your list. And that will also help with your budget. See, this spans more than just your health. This spans to your finances. It spans to, oh, wait, I don't have to sit here and worry and fret about what I didn't take out of the freezer. I already have it prepared. So prepare for the week. Number two, plan for the day. The night before, review the meals that you want, and you can even have some foods cooked in advance to cut down on the time you spend in the kitchen. I do that with like my chickens. I do that with my hamburgers. Now, steaks, not so much. But what I do is if I can, when I bring home my hamburger, if I know I have 3 or 4 meals that involve ground beef, I ground it all at the same time. I season it. Then I put it in individual proportions ready for those meals. So all I have to do is grab it out of the fridge or even grab it out of the freezer. I love buying in bulk and that helps. So plan for the day before. If you need to take out food, it's a great time to take it out the night or even the day before. And since you've already prepared for the week, planning for the day comes easy. And finally, number three, feast on the goodness. My favorite. Who doesn't want to feast on the goodness? Enjoy the bountiful goodies, new recipes, and the fellowship with the fam. Oh yeah, I like to say feast on food, family, and fun. A recipe for your everyday success. Is that really what your lifestyle looks like now? You see, our diet just doesn't have to be about the food. It's about everything else that goes along with it. Did you know that actually sitting down together as a family to eat reduces stress in the household? It also brings what? More togetherness. It allows you to be more cohesive as a family unit. Also important in crazy stormy times as such as these. So it's important for us to prep and plan and then feast. It's not always about just saying, okay, healthy living is where it is. Yes, it is, but it's a healthy lifestyle. So what do you think? Is the juice worth the squeeze? I think I know your answer. Give it your best for a week. Make note of how you feel, how your family enjoys the time together, and where the lifestyle isn't about easy, but more about presence. You see, food, it's not just about nutrition. It's about coming together. It's about sharing. It's about loving. It's about creating hope within the family. And you can do that every single day. You don't need to get stressed out about it. You don't need to raise your cortisol level. Oh no, none of that needs to happen. All you have to do is prep and plan and allow presence to take over. Go out today, train for life, and love your journey. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.